Hello lovies, welcome back to my channel. And if you're new here, my name is Maruth and welcome to you too. This is another Tip Tuesdays video. And in this video, we are going to talk about how to secure a Korean visa if you are a businessman, a house husband or housewife, a student, an OFW, or a retired senior citizen. So kung interesado kang malaman kung paano makakuha ng Korean visa, please keep on watching. So I've received a lot of questions nung ginawa ko yung video ko kung paano kumuha ng Korean visa. Ililink ko na lang somewhere in the screen or sa description box kung paano kumuha ng Korean visa kung ikaw ay isang empleyado. Yung first 5 requirements sa pagkuha ng Korean visa ay pare-parehas whether you are a businessman, a student, a house husband or housewife, an OFW, or a retired senior citizen. Ano yung limang yon? Number 1 is a duly accomplished application form. You can download that from the website of the Korean Embassy na dedicated para sa Philippines. Number 2 is a passport size na photo. Number 3 is your original passport that should be valid for more than 6 months. Number 4 is a photocopy of the bio page. Ito yung page na mayroong picture ninyo at pangalan ninyo as well as the passport number. And the 5th requirement is the original and photocopies of your visas and arrival stamps to OECD countries for the last 5 years. So yung limang yon, common yan sa kahit sinong mag-a-apply for Korean visas. Magdedepende na lang kung ano pang additional documents ang kailangan yung isama, depende kung anong designation ninyo sa sarili ninyo. Unahin natin ang mga taong may business. Yung unang additional requirement will be your business registration sa DTI or SEC. Yung pangalawa is a photocopy of your mayor's permit. Third is the original personal bank certificate, which will include the type of account that you have with the bank, yung average daily balance, yung current balance, at kung kailan nyo inopen yung account sa banko ninyo. The next is your bank statements for the past 3 months. This can be original or a certified true copy. Kung may passbook naman kayo, pwede rin yung passbook ang ipresent ninyo. Next is a photocopy of your ITR. And lastly, your PRC ID or an IBP kung applicable yon sa'yo. Next is for students. Kung estudyante ka, kailangan mo pa rin yung unang 5 na banggit ko plus itong mga additional documents na to. Number 1 is an original school certificate. Number 2 is a photocopy of your school ID. Number 3 is a copy of your birth certificate. And number 4 will be your parents' documents. So ano yung mga parents' documents na kailangan mong isama? First is a copy of their NSO marriage certificate, copy of their ITR, your parents' original bank certificate, nakasama rin kung ano yung account type, average daily balance, current balance, at kung kailan inopen yung bank account, original or certified true copies of your parents' bank statements, or their passbook for the past 3 months. Kung ang parents mo naman ay empleyado, they will also need to provide their COE, which will include yung kanilang position, date of hire, compensation, the office address, HR landline number, and HR email. Kung ang parents mo naman ay self-employed, they will need to present their certificate of registration from SEC or DTI, their business permit or mayor's permit. Ito naman ang mga additional documents kung ikaw naman ay isang house husband or housewife. Aside dun sa unang 5 na banggit ko kanina, kailangan nyo i-present ang copy ng inyong NSO marriage certificate, yung original mo or ng asawa mong bank certificate, which will include account type, ADB, current balance, at yung kung kailan inopen yung bank account, original or certified true copy ng bank statements mo o bank statement ng asawa mo for the past 3 months. kung ang asawa mo naman ay employed, kailangan ding i-present ng asawa mo ang certificate of employment niya kasama yung date hire, compensation, at yung HR details. Kung ang asawa mo naman ay self-employed, kailangan din niyang i-present ang business registration niya or mayor's permit. Kasama rin yung certificate of registration na manggagaling sa SEC or DPI. Kung ikaw naman ay retired senior citizen, ito naman ang additional requirements na kailangan mong dalhin aside from the 5 that I mentioned earlier. Your original personal bank certificate, again kasama yung mga details na nabanggit ko kanina, bank statements for the past 3 months, and a copy of your senior citizen ID. Kung ikaw naman ay OFW, definitely wala kang ITR. So, we will just need to present the bank documents na nire-require ng Korean Embassy, yung bank certificate at yung bank statements. As an additional requirement, yung mga OFW friends ko na nag-apply for Korean visas, idinagdag din nila doon yung pass nila as well as their employment contract. Sana nakatulong sa inyo ang video na to. Comment down below kung meron kayong mga questions. Please consider subscribing if you haven't already at i-click mo na rin ang bell button para ma-notify kayo kapag may bago akong video. I'll see you next time, lovies! Bye!